welcome to Prime News. First, a look at the headlines. Trouble time for Rane's. SIT asked financial details of Pratapsingh and Vishwajit Rane in Dahej mineral bribery case. 50 banks submit details. Ruby builder responsible for death of 31 labourers out on bail. Court grants relief in spite police stating accused builders not cooperating with investigation. Government starts understanding regional plan 3 years after coming to power. DCP does PowerPoint presentation. No clarity on what path government would follow to solve the issue. Salgaonkar Football Club hold Mohan Bagan to goalless draw in I-League ordinary finishing, let down both teams. And Goa Olympic Association bids farewell to 115 member contingent for National Games. Opening ceremony of Kerala Games on Saturday, Team Goa expected to better Ranchi Games medal tally. Now the news in detail. Special investigation team is proning details of all financial transactions of Pratapsingh Rane and Vishwajit Rane from various banks for allegedly taking bribe from Dahej Minerals. Till now, nearly 50 banks have submitted details to the SIT. Meanwhile, SIT has decided to summon 16 mines officials.
Balchandra Naik, chairman of Dahej Minerals, had alleged that Pratapsingh Rane had demanded a bribe of 6 crore rupees for clearing a mining lease. Balchandra had claimed that the money was accepted by Vishwajit Rane. To check the financial transactions of Rane's, special investigation team has sent letters to all the national and cooperative banks in Goa. Sources from the banks have informed that SIT has asked for all financial details. Details of financial transactions of Pratapsingh Rane and Vishwajit Rane. Financial transaction details from 2011 onwards. Nearly 50 national and cooperative banks submitted financial details of Rane's to SIT. SIT is investigating the details of transactions. Sources informed that SIT is investigating whether the alleged bribe of 6 crores amount has been paid through cheques or cash. SIT is waiting for more banks to submit financial transactions of Rane's. Deputy Inspector General of Police K.K. Vyas, heading the Special Investigation Team, has taken review meeting on the mining investigation. Sources informed that SIT has decided to issue summon to 16 mines officials to investigate the role in the alleged illegal mining case. On Wednesday, SIT interrogated Assistant Geologist Ramnath Shedgaonkar in Anil Salgaonkar illegal mining case. They were questioned on lease documents, payment of royalty and export by lease holders. More mines officials will be interrogated by the SIT. Reporter Mahesh Gadi for Prudent.
Builders allegedly responsible for the death of 31 innocent men after Ruby residency collapsed due to faulty construction are out on bail. They are walking free as court feels that they need not be in police or judicial custody. More importantly, they have been granted bail even when their whereabouts during the last 1 year are not known. They are out in spite of police telling the court that the accused are not cooperating with the investigation. Meanwhile, Crime Branch has written a letter to Interpol seeking clarification of communication regarding Billing's location in Manchester in UK.
The accused builders Pardeep Singh Biring and Jagdeep Sehgal, who are allegedly responsible for death of 31 persons, are released on bail by the court within 12 days of their arrest. Crime Branch had to wait more than 1 year to track and arrest them. But it failed to convince the court to get police remand for more than 5 days, even though mystery behind their hideout is still unresolved. While granting regular bail to accused builders Pardeep Singh Biring and Jagdeep Sehgal on Wednesday, the Panji Special Court put certain conditions on them. As per court's conditions, accused Pardeep Singh Biring and Jagdeep Sehgal have to furnish personal bail bond of 2 lakh rupees each. two local sureties, each of like amount. Biring and Sehgal have to appear before investigating officer for 15 days. Both have to remain present in crime branch between 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Crime branch can call them for questioning on any day till filing of charge sheet. Both Biring and Sehgal cannot visit municipal area of Kankon. Both have to surrender their passports. According to sources, during the interrogation by crime branch, accused builders have completely blamed accused contractor for collapse of building. Crime branch is almost ready with the charge sheet in this case, but investigators are yet to finalize role of accused builders in the building collapse. Crime branch is still clueless about the location of Biring during last 1 year. Passport details of Biring does not show any visit to a foreign country after building collapse on 4th January 2014. Reporter Mukesh Kumar for Prudent.
It's been 3 years since BJP has come to power, but government has just now begun study of the regional plan. Town and Country Planning Department is updating Chief Minister and Deputy CM on regional plan through PowerPoint presentation. The first presentation was cut short halfway as it was too lengthy. After completing the presentation, government will take up the regional plan issue. Government took 3 years to kickstart the understanding process. Now there is no clarity over how and when the regional plan will go through.
Erstwhile Congress government had created a chaos while formulating regional plan. BJP had made regional plan its election issue, cornered the government and came to power after winning assembly poll. But BJP government itself took 3 years to kickstart the regional plan work. These were BJP's assurances. On 20th March 2012, Governor's speech mentioned revoking notification of RP 2021 and reworking the plan in disputed zones. On 24 July 2014, government reiterates to fulfill RP assurance mentioned in Governor's speech. 7th August 2014, government assures to formulate sub-plans on panchayat level, finalizing plan after local inputs and approvals on people's vote. It's almost 3 years and incumbent government hasn't fulfilled a single assurance on RP. The draft plan in 2001 marked 12% land as settlement zone. 2021 plan reserved 15.35% land for settlement. This included industrial zones also. NGOs protested, citing that settlement zone was increased all of a sudden in the notified plan. Government issued a circular to keep the RP 2021 on hold. It was decided to approve development only those settlement zones which were common and featured in both 2001 and 2021 regional plan. But later, people and activists exposed ample number of cases which exposed how constructions were carried out in conflicting settlement zones. Erstwhile government had kept the plan open in 2011 for inputs and objections from public. Almost 50% public proposals were demanding increase in settlement zones. This aspect will pose a challenge for the incumbent BJP government. Last week, Chief Minister and Deputy Chief Minister were updated by Town and Country Planning Department on the regional plan. Next meet is scheduled on 3rd February. Right now, government has begun study of the history of regional plan. Thereafter comes the geography of the plan and later government will revise it with modifications and conflicting zones. But there is no concrete plan as of date by when this exercise will conclude. Senior reporter Lokik Shilkar with video journalist Omkar Prahari for Prudent.
It's time for a short break. Stay tuned.